to be able to transfer your model from Revit to Unreal Engine, you need two plugins. The first plugin, you can install the first plugin from your Epic Launcher from Unreal Engine port, and then in Library tab, you need to scroll down and uninstall your Unreal Datasmith. It is the Unreal Engine version, but for your third-party program like Revit, ArchiCAD, 3ds Max, or other kind of or other supported softwares, you need to go to the browser and type Datasmith plugin, and you need to go to this link and install the appropriate version with your third-party program. For example, I have installed the Revit exporter, so I'm not going to do it again, but you need to install it. It is really easy to install this plugin, so I'm not going to show you the process. Okay, let us close this browser and let's go to the Revit. Let's go back a little bit. Okay, to export your Revit file, you need to go to the 3D view. And when you install the Datasmith, it will add a new tab called Datasmith in your Revit software. To export your file, you need to go to the Datasmith tab and then click on Export 3D View. Then you need to assign a place for exported file, and after that you can export it. Let's save our file on our desktop and let's call it, the name is good because it is according to our project name, so it is good for me. Just click on save, and the time will be about 1 minute to maybe 20 minutes or 30 minutes according to your model. Because this model is not very complicated, it's going to be maybe a minute or two. Let me, we should wait to end of our exporting process. When your export has finished, you need to go to the Unreal Engine. So we don't have any other work in Revit, we can minimize it. And let's go to the Epic Game Launcher. You can launch whatever your version is, but I'm going to work with 4.25 for this tutorial. Let me click on launch and let us wait that the engine will start soon. After launching Unreal Engine, you will see this window that will allow us to select our template. Click on architecture, engineering, and construction because we are going to work on an AIC project. So I'm going to use this template. Click here and click on next, and then you have to click on blank because we want a blank project. So just you need click on blank and click on next. And in this step, you can enable your ray tracing if you have an RTX graphic card, and also you can enable your static content too. I'm going to enable both of them, and also you can assign a place for your project from here. I'm okay with the default path, so I'm going to click on create project, and we should wait for the initializing of our project. When you open Unreal Engine, you will see this interface, and when you install the Datasmith in your main toolbar, you will have a new icon that called Datasmith. To import your third-party file, you need to click on Datasmith and then choose your exported file. We exported our files on our desktop, so let us go to the desktop and select your exported file and click on Open. Okay, and after that, it will allow you to create a folder in your outline, and that will allow us to organize our project data better. Let me create a new folder here, and let me call it Revit file. And then you need to click on OK. Before that, this is the last step that will allow you to specify the elements that you want in your Unreal Engine project. For example, I don't need lighting, camera, and animation because I'm going to do these things professionally in Unreal Engine. So I uncheck them, and I just want the geometry and material and textures. Okay, this is good for me. And then you can click on import. Now you can wait, and your file will be imported very soon. Now you see your file has imported very easily and very fast, and you can go and walk through your project very easily and visualize your project for your client, for your firm, or for other persons. And now you can start your process for lighting, texturing, or other kind of things. The last step, let me, for example, put a light here. But first, let us delete the sky. Let me delete it. And now we can create lights easily. For example, let me put a light here and let me move it up. Now you can see you can do the lighting very easily in your Unreal Engine. Okay, for example, the last step here, if your original file has changed, you should know a tip that you can update your files because you don't like to do all these processes again and again. The last step here is, for example, let us assume that our architect has changed the roof. For example, he has reset the shape of the roof, and now roof is flat, not with slopes. And to update your file in your Unreal Engine 2, you just need to replace your file with the older version. For example, to do that, you need to go to the Datasmith tab and click on Export 3D View, and then go to the last place that you saved the older version, for example, on my desktop in this case, and you just need to replace this with the older version. Click on Save and click Yes to replace this file with the older version. When your export has finished, you can go back to the Unreal Engine, and you need to, let us go to the roof and let me put a light here. For example, let's see the roof. You can see there is a slope here. Here you can see it better. But in the new revision, we don't have any slope on our roofs. So you just need to go to the content browser and click right-click on your project file and just click on re-import, and it will be update, and it will update your project. Check your geometry and material and textures and click on import. It will update our file very easily and very fast, and we don't lose any other kind of working like lighting or texture in our Unreal Engine. Click on press F to focus on our selected object. And now you can see there is no slope right now. Okay. This is the full process, and also you can leverage this process and implement this process for all of the other softwares like 3D Max, ArchiCAD, and SketchUp and Rhino.